What's up, YouTube? So in this video, I'm going to do a review and rating for the Moose Knuckles Ballistic Bomber Jacket. So here's the jacket. It's a size medium. Let's get into reviewing this jacket. It's definitely a little bit more of a louder style. You have this contrasting chrome zipper here. You have these metal studs. And then you also have this fox fur trim on it. So I rate and review my jackets based on four things. Those things are functionality, features, quality, and finally comfort. I'll start with the functionality of this jacket. So for a down-filled jacket like this, you're gonna expect to stay pretty warm. Also, you're gonna want some protection from the wind and rain. And this jacket does a pretty good job of that. I would compare this jacket with the warmth of a Canada's Chilliwack. So when I was testing this out on a windier day, I did notice some of the wind tended to seep through the zipper on the front of the jacket. When it comes to rain and wind protection, this jacket's not waterproof, so you don't obviously want to be caught out in like a heavy rainstorm or a lot of snow, but this jacket will keep you pretty dry when it's just some mild precipitation. Now for the hood does a pretty good job of keeping your face and head warm. You can snap the hood a little bit closer to your face. So I've worn downfield bomber jackets that give me a little bit better protection than this coat. Now, still doesn't mean this jacket won't keep you pretty warm, especially in most, you know, climates that you're in. I'd be a little worried about it in extreme conditions. But overall, for the functionality of this jacket, I give it a 7.5 out of 10. All right, so next up is features. Now, the front of the jacket has a large YKK zipper on the front here. You also have two lower drop-down pockets. They're fleece-lined, and they're pretty large. You also have these higher hand-worn pockets, and they're also fleece-lined. You have heavy-duty ribbed cuffs here. On the left arm of the jacket, you have the Moose Knuckles logo. Inside the jacket, you have a pocket right here, Napoleon pocket, zipper enclosure on it. For the hood, so this jacket has a removable hood. There's snaps right here. You can snap the hood right off. You're not able to remove the fur off the hood though. So I generally like to have two front zippers on the jacket just so I can zip the jacket up a little bit and give my legs a little bit more freedom. I kind of wish I had that. I was a little bummed there wasn't more pockets in the jacket. There's just one pocket right here. I definitely felt like you could have added a drop down pocket or just another pocket inside the jacket. So overall, this jacket has some features that I enjoy, but I also feel like it could have added features just to make it a little bit more practical. I'm gonna give this jacket a 6.5 out of 10 when it comes to features. All right, so next up is comfort. I did notice these jackets are pretty comfortable. So they're a bomber length jacket and they're down-filled, so they're light, and they usually cling about at your waist, which just gives you more freedom of motion. So I really like that about these jackets, the fact that you can pack a lot of warmth in such a light and not very cumbersome thing is pretty cool to me. The exterior of this jacket doesn't feel too rigid. It feels like it's a nice blend of fabrics. I don't really like stiff jackets. I kind of wish they'd add a chin guard here, just because when I zip the jacket up, I did notice that the chin guard, or the top part, does kind of rub against my chin. So overall, I found this jacket pretty comfortable. I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10 when it comes to comfort. All right, so next up is quality. So taking into consideration the price of this jacket, the quality I found to be, you know, decent but not great. The biggest knock on the quality, at least for me, is just this front zipper. So I don't really like how the zipper is already puckered a bit. If you can see, it's a little bit wavy here. I also just don't like the metal that was used in it or something, because it doesn't feel that natural when I'm zipping it up. It tends to get stuck a little bit, like especially up here. And I just feel like they could have used a higher quality zipper on the front of the jacket. In terms of other aspects of the jacket, the rib cuffs feel of pretty high quality. I was pleased with that. I'd say it's comparable to Canada Goose. I was pleased with the quality of the exterior fabric as well. There's also nice fleece lining in these hand-worn pockets, which is just a nice feature. So I did like the fox fur trim on the jacket. I felt the fur trim felt softer, a lot softer than coyote fur, and in my opinion, it just kind of looked nicer. So all in all, in terms of quality, I give this jacket a 7 out of 10. So here's our overall score for the Moose Knuckles Ballistic Bomber Jacket.